Hello there guys, my name is Curtis Shaw, Dogs to the Board built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom update from the Alton Towers Resort. I just saw the news, apparently it was yesterday, but I just saw the news come out and I felt like I wanted to do a video on this. Now of course you'll have seen the first video today, an interview with SNS director Lars Lenders. Stay tuned because next week we've got another exciting interview also with SNS, but stay tuned for that one next week. But make sure go back and watch the interview with Lars. Brilliant to chat with that guy. Lovely guy. Brilliant to talk about SNS and what they've been doing in terms of projects and to talk about this year's projects. So check out that video. But this news update is all about Alton Towers, and this is about the possibly returning virtual queue system that could be coming back for the 2021 season. Now, this is not confirmed in any way, shape or possible, but we are going to look at a news article from Tower Street about this news. Now, before we get started with all of that, make sure you like the video if you loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions on this, guys. Subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss another theme park newsroom update or any video. We're getting closer and closer to 4,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and also 1 million views by the end of the year in total. So please, let's go and achieve those goals by the end of 2021. Also, guys, make sure you go check out the description down below, where not only can you find links to the article with this, but you can also find links to Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, and also the Discord server, where you, yes, you, the Coast Chow fan base, could be a part of the Chow Nation and interact with other Coast Chow fans. And also, the Google Forms link is in the description down below, where you can submit your video ideas along with a shout out for your social media name, so we can give you guys the boost in your social media that you guys deserve, because you guys deserve just as much recognition as I've got. But for now, guys, let's have a look at all the information surrounding the return of a virtual queue system, possibly for the 2021 season, at the Alton Towers Resort. So this is from Tower Street, and they've officially reported that following the posting of job opportunities on the Merlin Careers website, it appears that Alton Towers Resort could be looking into trying a virtual queuing system for the 2021 theme park season. The job description title in question mentions that under remain responsibility section, bit of a word count there, it says being the point of contact for any guest inquiries or feedback regarding virtual queuing or the resort box office operation. And it says ensure all rental devices attributed to virtual queuing are well maintained, fully operational, signed in and out daily with any damages slash concerns reported to the commercial sales manager. It's anticipated that visitors to the theme park will be able to use the Alton Towers Resort app or similar web-based service to reserve a time to ride an attraction, as well as using the rental devices aforementioned the job description. Normally with the virtual queuing system, these time slots are based roughly on the length of time one would expect to wait in a normal line, and while in-line guests are free to wander the park and may choose to enjoy other attractions that are not using the virtual queuing system, however, they must ensure that they return to the reserved attraction within the time window to be granted access. Now, similar systems have been used in other parks, such as the Fastpass Plus system at Disney. However, back in 2020, many more attractions include the system with this nature in an attempt to reduce the number of people standing in line to better facilitate social distancing during this COVID-19 pandemic. Now, this would not be the first time Alton Towers has put in the virtual queuing system. If you guys that are diehard fans from back in the early 90s and even before that, do you remember the early 2000s when we had the virtual queuing system, which was available for free on Nemesis, Air, Black Hole, The Flume, and much, much more? The service was free of charge and was later replaced with the paid fast track system we see today. Details are currently few and but far between, but there'll be updates in the future when they hear more. Watch this space. You can also watch this space on Coast Chow YouTube channel. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. It's not officially announced from the park, but it's looking very, very likely we're going to see the return of the virtual queuing system for the first time since the early 2000s at the Alton Towers Resort. And like I said on the article, we've seen similar systems with the Fastpass Plus, with the Disney parks. I think there was a time actually at Thorpe Park quite a few years back now. I think there was like a separate app or a separate website completely from the park they worked in collaboration with or something. I must have seen something from like 2012, 2013, something like that. where you like a reserve the ride system. So it's going to operate kind of like that, where you reserve a ride time and you go to the ride on that time. It's like a VIP event, isn't it? You reserve your ride on a brand new ride's media day or something, and it's like, you know, it's like that, but on a daily park basis. So it looks like we're going to have this virtual park system. First of all, in terms of discussing my thoughts on this, if this is coming to Alton Towers, who's going to put the money on betting that this is going to go to Thorpe Park and Chessington World of Adventures and Heidi Park and Gardaland? You know, and it's kind of got references to York Dungeon and the dungeon attractions as well, because if you think about that, or even before the pandemic, with the dungeon attractions, you could reserve your booking as a group. You know, you could reserve a time to experience the dungeon. This is what we're experiencing here with different rides and attractions. Now, obviously, there's that discussion of, is it going to go to Thorpe? Is it going to go to Chessington, Heidi Park, Gardaland, other attractions to reserve your groups or times, etc., for midway attractions such as Madame Tussauds, Sea Life, the dungeons again, and much, much more. But another big discussion point is what rides would be available on the virtual queue system. I think all the thrill rides, let's be perfectly honest, I think all the thrill rides will be on there. Maybe not Enterprise or the Blade, but probably all the, probably most of the coasters, nearly all the coasters. Not maybe Spinball as well, but not Octonauts. We won't see Octonauts on there, but Spinball might be on there. Nemesis will probably be on there. Galactica, Smiler, Oblivion, Rita, 13 will probably on there. For the families, for a family virtual queuing system, you might get a couple of family attractions. So maybe Jewel's on there, Hex is on there. Maybe Gangster Grind of the Ride will be on that virtual queue system when it opens in 2021 as well, in the brand new area, the World of David Williams. So, you know, it's going to be very interesting to see what ride's going to be available. I mean, we've seen past evidence of, you know, before with the old virtual queuing system from the early 2000s. You know, we heard on that article, Nemesis was there, Air was there, Black Hole was there, the Flume was there. I think I said the Blade. I'm not sure if I said the Blade or not, but no, I think the Blade could be on there. I think the Blade would be probably on there. Yeah, and it's interesting, isn't it? It's really, really interesting. It's definitely going to be a wonderful service. I think that Alton Towers are going to do really, really well with this, and I think that overall, we are probably looking at a decent service here, and, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how they really do it. You know, it'd be interesting to see how it's been done and how it will work, you know, because I've not really experienced this kind of virtual queue system, so, you know, hopefully it will be a good experience to learn from in terms of the theme park experience. So it's going to be interesting to sort of have a look at all of this and see where this is all heading. You know, I did a video last year of something like, you know, should theme parks abolish queue lines? You know, should that happen? And this is kind of like this update is kind of like following on from that video in a way, because it's sort of like, well, it looks like Alton Towers are going to move into the virtual queue system this year. You know, if this goes well, even in a post-COVID world in a year or two time, you know, is this the end of the physical queue lines? You know, is this going to be, you know, the end of standing in lines, cramped lines, in queue lines, and, you know, having to experience the pre-show and have another group waiting outside, just outside, you know, standing in lines and waiting for an hour or two, etc., on a busy day? You know, is it the end of that? And is it just book your slot and reserve a ride? You know, is that going to be the process moving forward for the theme park? So it's going to be a very interesting discussion. And again, this is a potential another interview. It'd be nice to chat to someone about this kind of virtual queuing system and, you know, what is the future of theme parks moving forward. So it's very, very interesting. I think it's a very weird direction for Alton Towers to go. Obviously, it's not completely mysterious to Alton Towers. We know they've gone through this before with the virtual, not the pandemic, obviously, but we know they've gone through this with the virtual queuing system before, you know, and it was replaced by Fast Track. I think, in my personal opinion, if I'm being completely honest, Fast Track is very, very expensive. It's more expensive than I thought it would be when it first came in. And, you know, it's kept increasing ever since. So, in my opinion, if it's permanently going to be a replacement for the Fast Track, I say go for it. For those of you who struggle with Wi-Fi around the park, and I know you're probably going to be angry about this, but, you know, I think there should still be a Fast Track option, but make it cheaper for those people who struggle with Wi-Fi around the park. and they can go with the fast track option anyway. So I think once the COVID pandemic's gone and we're back to a normality of some sort, if they do want to bring the fast track back but keep the virtual queue system, keep the virtual queue system, but for those who struggle with Wi-Fi around the park to use the app or a separate website to book the slot for the virtual queuing system, I would have the fast track available as well, just in case. And I would have it at cheaper prices, because most people are going to be on the virtual queuing system, but the small majority of people who may not have the ability to use the virtual queue system around the park have that fast track option at a cheap price, so they're still making money from that. Because let's face it, the virtual queuing system will not be a cost. It won't cost. Let's face it, it'll be a free option. If it does cost, I'll be very surprised. I think it probably would cost, but not normal virtual queuing system. Like, I think that it would only cost if they do like a package of deals of virtual queuing. So let's say they had 5 ride queues in the space of an hour. So basically they had like bundles for virtual queuing, like you would get on these 5 rides in an hour for this price. And it's like the fast track kind of price. So you get on these rides, you queue up at the exit, and you get straight on these 5 rides in a space of time as part of this bundle kind of thing. Which I'm kind of thinking that's maybe the direction they'll probably go in the future if they're going to keep the virtual queuing system beyond 2021. So it should be very interesting. I'd love to know your thoughts on this, guys. But thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Go and watch that first video from today, the SNS interview with Lars Lenders. Absolutely wonderful guy. Love that guy. And great to talk to him. Great to talk to someone else from SNS next week. So stay tuned. But thank you very much, guys. My name is Coach Chow. Keep living the coast life. And I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an altantastic day. #virtual queuing.